Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Tech Edu for You. I am Harika. Today I am discussing about hash tables. We have the tables concept in the data structures. We exclusively discuss about the hash tables in this presentation itself. Okay, let's get started with our actual topic, tables. And we can go with the tables. Table is also a table is a non-linear data structure. When we go with stacks, queues, linked list, arrays, or those are the linear data structures. When we come with tables, this is the non-linear data structure. It consists of the rows and columns that stores the values. It can be used to store the data and display the data in a structured format by following the rows and columns. In first row, second column, in second row, third column, like that, will maintain the formatted structured format. Here we have the different types of tables in data structures, that are the rectangular tables, jagged tables, inverted tables, and hash tables. Exclusively in this video we can discuss about the hash tables. Hash tables uses the hash function to compute an index to into an array of buckets or slots. Here the hash table is also a data structure which is used to implement an associated arrays. Key value pairs are is also called as associative arrays or records. Here the hash table is an efficient method of implementing the dictionaries also. By using the hash function, we can map the dictionary pairs into the positions of the hash table. Let us consider a bucket array is used for the hash table. It is an array size of n. Each and every cell in the array is treated as a bucket. It is used to hold the key value pairs. We can use it to hold the key value pairs. When the item is looked up, the key is hashed to find the appropriate bucket. We have the table over here. We can form the associate array to the another one, and by using the techniques hash functions, using the hash functions, all the operations on the hash tables, such as the searching of a key value pair. Here we will follow the key value pairs, and inserting a key value pair or deleting a key value pair, all those can be done by using the hash functions only. These are nothing but the hash techniques or hash methods also. The different types of hash techniques are the truncation method, folding method, mid square method, and division method. These are the four different types of hash functions. In truncation method, we'll ignore some digits of the key and use the rest of the key as the array index. Here the method hash function h of the k is obtained by ignoring set of digits and remaining digits are combined to get the index of the hash table. For example, we can give the value is 784562, which is used to be stored in the 2-digit address. That is, the given key k is equal to 784562. H of k is equal to 75. We have taken the 2 digits from the overall key value, and the given value can be stored at the 75th index of the hash table. In this way, we can place the values in the hash table. Here the only 7th and 8th position digits are taken and form as the 75th index. Next, we are moving to the folding method. In folding method, the partition the given key value into number of parts, like that k1, k2, k3, and so on, kn. The k key into the n parts. The each part should contain the number of bits or digits as required the address bit. It should have the number of bits or digits as required for the address bit. If the key is in the binary form, then we'll apply the exclusive OR operations on for partition purpose. Otherwise, we can go with the addition operation for partitions. Okay, let us consider the same example. Key value is 784562, which is to be stored in 2-digit address. Then the given value, the given key value k is equal to 784562, address width is equal to 2. Then we can divide the whole number into two digits into the one part. 78 is the one K1, K2 45, K3 62. Now h of k is equal to 62 plus 45 plus 78, that is equal to 185. Now we are taking only the address width should be 2 digits. Now we are taking the leftmost 2 digits as the index of the hash table. The given value is stored at 18th index of the hash table. And variations on the folding method can be done by using the shifting and fold boundary method also. In fold shifting, the method even number of key partitions are reversed before the addition. We can partition the data by using the addition or by using the exclusive OR operations only. In fold boundary method, in boundary parts K1 and that is the K1 and K2, K3 and so on, Kn, the reversed before the addition. First value and last value of the keys can be reversed before the addition. Next, we are moving to the division method. One of the first and most widely used hash function is division hash function. In this method, the hash function is defined as h of k is equal to key divided by d. Here, d is called as the size of the hash table. We can say that k is a key value and d is the size of the hash table. H of k is the hash function. We can define the h of k is equal to k divided by key modulo divided by. Here we are not doing the normal division. Here we are doing the modulo division. K is divided by d. We can write the prime numbers instead of the size of the hash table only. Okay, now let us consider the another example for this method. Insert the key value 31 into the hash table of the size 4. The given key value k is equal to 31 and the size of the hash table d is equal to 4. Now h of k is equal to 31 modulo divided by 4. Here the modulo division takes the which value? It takes the modulo division takes the quotient value. And the given 31 is stored as the third index of the hash table. Now we are moving to the mid square method. In mid square method, the hash function is defined as the h of k is equal to x, where x is obtained by the selecting an appropriate number of digits from the middle of the square of the key value. Okay, let us consider the k is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. K square is equal to 1, 5, 2, 2, 7, 5, 6. How we can write these digits? By using the k square. And h of k square is equal to 5, 2, 5. Here we are writing the x value, where x is obtained by the selecting the appropriate number of digits from the middle of the square of the given values. So we have taken 5, 2 as one digit, 5 digit, 2 digit, and 5 digit. We have given the middle values 5 and under one more middle value 2 and one more middle value 5. we can store the value 1, 2, 3, 4 at 525 index of the hash table. In this way, we can do the hash functions. When the table with the n elements and the m positions, n less than or equal to m is considered, then to assign their elements, hash functions can be used by using these methods. Now we are moving to the collision. When the hash function maps two different keys to the same location, then collision occurs. Thus, the corresponding records can't be stored in the same location. Then we'll go for array with four records with two fields, one for key computed, another for to hold the data consider. This is nothing but the collision technique. Okay, when two or more keys is tried to locate or access the same location, the hash table is known as the collision. That particular situation is nothing but the collision. Then we are inserting the 4, 7, 15, 16 into the hash table of size 5. The key 4, h of 4 is 4. H of 7 is 2, H of 15 is 0, and H of 60 is 0. Now collision occurred at index 0th location. The first come first serve we have followed, we have put the 15 over here, but the 60 value, we can't place the 60 value over here. There occurs a collision. To overflow the collision, when there is no empty locations to insert the key value into hash table is known as the overflow. We can insert the key values into the hash table of the size 5. At this stage, we tried to insert the another key, overflow occurred since the hash table is with the full of elements. The overflow can be avoided by determining the table which is greater than the number of inserting keys by making the keys. Next, we are moving with the collision resolution techniques. There are two collision resolution techniques, separate chaining method and next one open addressing method. That is nothing but the closed hashing, open addressing or closed hashing, separate chaining method. Closed hashing, this is the simple method to resolve the collisions, is called the closed hashing. In here, we will perform the linear probing, quadratic probing, double hashing and rehashing techniques. In separate chain method, we will go with the chaining or separate chaining or open hashing can be done. Okay, separate chain method is nothing but the open hashing method. Closed hashing method is nothing but the open addressing method. Here we should know open addressing or closed hashing, open hashing or separate chain method. In closed chain method, the simplest method to resolve the closed hashing method, it is the simplest method. Then the alternate locations are tried until all the empty locations are found. This can be done by using the linear probing, that is nothing but the searching, quadratic probing, double hashing and rehashing. We are moving with the linear probing. In linear probing, the popular choice to obtain the empty location is f of I is equal to I. Here I is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Here we are inserting the values 4, 7, 15, 60. We can found the key values by using the h of 4 is equal to 4 modulo divided by 5 and k of 7 is equal to k modulo divided by 7. In this way we can do the collisions. You can see the example over here. One second. I am placing this example. Okay. This collision occurred at the index 0. We are applying the linear probing. F of I is equal to I is equal to 1. F of 1 is equal to 1. Next location from the collision. That is, the collision occurred at the 0th location. The next location refers to the location 1, which is empty. Hence, the key 60 is inside that the first location of the hash table. Next, we are moving with the quadratic probing. Quadratic, in linear probing, the popular choice to obtain the empty location and we'll place there. And here, we can place like this. This is the example for the quadratic probing. First, we will perform the linear probing. And f of I is equal to I square. We will follow here f of I is equal to I square. Previously, in linear probing, f of I is equal to I. Here, the f of I is equal to I square. In this way, we will insert the values in the hash table. Next, we are moving with the double hashing method. In double hashing, the popular choice is to obtain the empty location f of k is equal to I star h slash of k, h dash of k. Here, h dash of k is equal to q minus k modulo division q. By using these formulas, we can calculate the location of the index and we will insert the values like this. By seeing this example, you clearly understand that first we have divided the modulo division. Collision has occurred over here, 89 and 49. So, for the remaining element is 18. 18 can be located at 8th index. We can place this element. Now, we need to place the 89 and 49. And 58, for 58 the location is 3, that can be stored over here. Now we are moving with the collision, clearing the collision and placing the 89 and 49 we'll do the 5th location, and for that we'll go with the next location 40. In 6th location, 6th index, we'll go with that and we will place the 49 over here and 89 over here. Next, we are moving with the rehashing technique. In rehashing concept, if we are moving the half of the location and fill it with the records, then we'll go with the other table and we'll place that key values. Next, we are moving with the open hashing method. Open hashing method is also known as the separate chaining method. In this method, the hash table uses the array of pointers. Each pointer is linked to the linked list. In inserting the values 10, 24, 12, 23, 26, like that, we are inserting and so on up to 54. Hash table with the size 10. Then we will go with the separate linked list for the open addressing, separate chaining method. For the location, we will place the separate linked list, and in that linked list, we will place the elements. Here, 2 for 12 and 32. They can be placed at the 2 index by using the separate linked list. In this way, we will place the separate linked list. Next, in open hashing method, we will go for bucket hashing. Here, bucket hashing is another closed method, closed hashing resolution technique. In open hashing, in bucket hashing, another hash table with m slots are divided into the buckets B. Their overflow of the buckets can be placed in the overflow buckets. Or we'll insert the values over here. By using the key value, we'll calculate the key values and place them into the hash table. similarly as we have done previously. The overflow, if there exists in any overflow, then that overflow elements can be placed in the overflow buckets. Okay, here I have explained the open hashing and closed hashing functions to avoid the collisions in the hash table. Then we will place the element in the appropriate index. In this way we will insert the elements in the hash table. Thank you. That's all for today's topic. Thank you once again. Please subscribe to my channel. I will provide the much more information in next videos also. Thank you so much.